I refuse to live a wasteful life in the name of Jesus. I refuse to live a wasteful life in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray wherever you are. I refuse to live a wasteful life in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Can sinners make heaven? Can sinners make heaven? This is the question that we need to answer. But for us to answer this question, we need the word of God. Wherever we are, let's open our Bible to the book of Romans chapter 3 verse 23. Book of Romans, chapter 3, verse 23. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Children of God, this Bible passage stated that all of us are sinners and therefore deserve eternal death. But because God is love and full of grace, he made the provision for his son Jesus Christ to come and die on the cross of Calvary for our sin, so that we can live forever with him. That's what the Bible said in the book of John chapter 3 verse 16, that for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish but have an everlasting life. This gives us salvation of the forgiveness of sin and of eternal life. Is something we can't earn but receive by God's grace. Anyone and everyone can get it if they believe in God and accept the gift by faith. When we look at the great love of Jesus Christ, his death on the cross for us, we become aware that we are sinners in need of a savior, and we turn to him and grab hold of the free gift. Wherever you are, for by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourself, it is the gift of God, not of work, lest anyone should boast. It is the work of flesh that make one sin. Wherever you are you a sinner? I congratulate you. You will make heaven. Are you a fornicator? You will make heaven. Are you an adulteress? You will make heaven. Murderers, you will make heaven. You kill people physically, even with the word of your mouth. Are you a drunkard? You will make heaven. I know many will be saying, what is this pastor saying? It's like this pastor is drunk. This is heresy. What kind of teaching is this? Brethren, I'm saying it again. If you are a sinner, you will make heaven, because Jesus has come to this world for you. Wherever you are, I want you to open your Bible to the book of Luke chapter 5 verse 32. Book of Luke chapter 5 verse 32. I came not to call the righteous but sinner to repentance. I came not to call the righteous but sinner to repentance. I congratulate you if you are a sinner. Jesus has come for you. But one thing that can hinder you as a sinner not to make heaven is if you fail to stop committing those sins. If you fail to repent, you cannot make heaven. Brethren, God does not want us to stay sinner So he now starts to change us into the person he wants us to be. We cannot change ourselves. All we can do is to let him live and work in us. Jesus said that the key to eternal life with him is to know him, which means to have a relationship with Jesus. We all know that a relationship depends on communication for success. So we talk to God every day in prayer and through his word. Don't allow the work of flesh to destroy your heaven. Wherever we are, let's open our Bible to the book of Galatians chapter 5. We are reading from verse 19 to 21. Book of Galatians chapter 5 from verse 19 to 21. Now the work of the flesh are manifest, which are these: adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulations, wrath, strife, sedition, heresies, envying, murders, drunkenness, reviling, and such like, of the which I tell you before, as I have also told you in time past, that they which do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. Can we hear it? Once you are doing all this, you cannot inherit the kingdom of God. If you have all this stated in the book of Galatians chapter 5 verse 19 to 21 in your life, you will not be granted admission to heaven. And it is given with such clarity that no one be deceived by the many smooth talking false prophets that have now overspread the land, promising eternal life on them that are not recognized nor sanctioned in the Bible. Now it is an undeniable fact that every person who has ever lived on the planet has fallen into one or more of category listed in that Bible passage. God did not send Jesus into this world to condemn anyone, but rather to save as many as are willing to be saved. You need to let go and forget about your old way. Start a new life through Christ Jesus. Don't be a bad example to others. Many have been in that position, but today they have given their life to Jesus Christ. It is not too late for you to accept Jesus in your life today. I want you to know, you have been denying so many things, good things that are supposed to have happened in your life, but because of that flesh, that fornication, adultery, murders, witchcraft, wickedness, all form of evil things in your life, spirit of fornication and adultery in your life. Only you, without a car, you have 3, 4 and more ladies or woman friend. What of if you have a car? How many will you have? Enough is enough. You are an armed robber, stealing everywhere. You defraud people, claim to be what you are not. Do you know how many numbers of people that God has sent to you to preach the gospel, but you rejected? Many like to call some sweet path in the Bible to cover their sin. Brethren, some even use the example, the life of Paul the apostle. When he was Saul, they will say, when the time comes, God will arrest me as he has arrested Saul in the Bible. Are you Saul? The grace and the opportunity received by Paul the apostle on his way to Damascus, you might not receive it. This is another opportunity for you to accept Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior. Because the Bible makes us to understand in the book of Luke chapter 4 verse 18, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, and recovery of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised, wherever you are. If you have entered into any evil covenant with any occultic power, with any wicked powers, with the devil, this is a great opportunity for you to come out and accept Jesus as your Lord and your personal Savior. Tomorrow might be too late. You need to be cleansed from all unrighteousness. No sinner will enter heaven, for God cannot avoid to turn heaven into a sinful place like earth. Only the repentance, forgiving, transformed person who desperately long for and enter into the relationship with God will be there. That is why we ask for forgiveness of our sin and turn away from them. If we are serious about this relationship, we will spend time with him and ask him to show us any unconfessed sin. We are saved only by Jesus' death for us and no other way. Jesus is the only way to salvation and to make it to heaven. Peradventure you are listening under the sound of my voice and you have made up your mind that you want to surrender your life to the Lord Jesus. Wherever you are, I want you to lay your right hand on your chest and you will say after me. Say, Father, I come before you now. Lord Jesus, come into my life. Take control of my life. As from today, I say bye-bye to the devil. I enter into the kingdom of light. In the name of Jesus. Amen. I congratulate us. We have made the right choice for our life. Wherever we are, let us open our mouth and begin to confess now. Say, Father, forgive me. Every known and unknown sin, Father, forgive me. In the name of Jesus, Father, forgive me all my sins, O Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, have mercy upon my life. In the name of Jesus, for in Jesus' wonderful name we pray. Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, I thank you, Lord, for the life of those that accepted Jesus into their life today. Father, forgive every known and unknown sin. Father, Lord, have mercy upon their life in the name of Jesus. Have mercy upon your children in the name of Jesus. Father, by your mercy, O Lord, baptize them with your Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus. And let your name alone be glorified. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Blessed be your holy name. For in Jesus' wonderful name we pray. Amen. Let's open our mouths and begin to worship the Lord. Glorify the name of the Lord. Give thanks to the Lord for the gift of life. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Thank you, King of Glory. In Jesus' wonderful name we pray. Amen. Brethren, I want us to pray. But before we pray, for the Bible makes us understand, according to the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 17, that therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. If you miss heaven, you cannot miss hell. You will shout loud and clear, say, the voice of I die, no. I would not have lived my life this way. Will not be my Lord. In the name of Jesus, the voice of I die, no. I would have lived my life this way. Will not be my Lord. In the name of Jesus, the voice of I die, no. I would have lived my life this way. Will not be my Lord. In the name of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Say, heaven will not reject me. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray now. Heaven will not reject me. In the name of Jesus, heaven will not reject me. In the name of Jesus, heaven will not reject me. In the mighty name of Jesus, heaven will not reject me. In the name of Jesus, at the end of everything in this world, heaven will not reject me. In the mighty name of Jesus, in Jesus mighty name we pray. Amen. Are you ready to take the last prayer in this session? Say, all my effort in life will not end in a fire. In the name of Jesus, all my effort in life will not end in a fire. In the name of Jesus, all my effort in life will not end in a fire. In the name of Jesus, all my effort in life will not end in a fire. In the mighty name of Jesus, for in Jesus' wonderful name we pray. Amen. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Father, we thank you because you are the Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, we thank you because you are God. Glory be to your holy name, in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, your children has cried loud unto thee, O Lord. Accept our thanksgiving in the name of Jesus. Accept our worship in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we say thank you, Lord, for the gift of life. Thank you for counting us worthy to be among the living, to see the light of today. We return all the glory unto thee. Blessed be your holy name, in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, have mercy, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Father, have mercy, O Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, at the end of everything in this world, Heavenly Father, let us make it to heaven. In the name of Jesus, the voice of I know you not, you workers of iniquities, shall not be our lot, shall not be our portion. In the mighty name of Jesus, all our service on earth shall not be in vain. In the mighty name of Jesus, oh God, arise, have mercy, oh Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, thank you, Heavenly Father. Thank you, King of Kings. Thank you, Lion of the tribe of Judah. We return all the glory, honor, adoration unto thee. Let your name alone be glorified. Blessed be your holy name. For in Jesus' wonderful name we pray. Amen. 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 In Jesus' name, let's share the grace and fellowship. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. 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 In Jesus' name, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. God bless you all. Have a wonderful day, in the name of Jesus. Amen.